Boys and girls of every age, won't you like to see something strange? Well, come with us and you will see. I am actually doing a Halloween movie review on The Nightmare Before Christmas from 1993. So, let's get this started. Cue the intro, please. Hey guys, Jonathan's Media Shack here again, and today, here is my movie review on Tim Burton's The Nightmare Before Christmas. Came in the year of 1993. It's basically what the plot's about. It follows the misadventures of Jack Skellington, who is Halloween Town's most beloved Pumpkin King, who had became, all of a sudden became bored with the same annual routine of frightening people in the real world. But when Jack accidentally stumbles on Christmas Town, all bright colors and warm-hearted spirits, he gets a new lease on life, and he plots to bring Christmas under his control by kidnapping Santa Claus, and taking over the world. But Jack soon discovers that even the best-laid plans of mice and skeleton men can go seriously awry, and he has to find a way to fix it and stop the Oogie Boogie and save Christmas as well. And that's basically what the plot is. Guys, what do I think about this movie? I think this is a really cool Tim Burton film. Yeah, I personally enjoyed The Nightmare Before Christmas. The animation looks absolutely cool. Like this is a Tim Burton film. Yes. And when it comes to Tim Burton, he does have great skills, and the animation that he used for it looks absolutely superb. And Jack Skellington is a really great character. Yeah. Jack Skellington, he's a great character. He is also the Pumpkin King of Halloween. And he also has a ghost dog named Zero, who has a small glowing jack-o'-lantern nose. And then we got Sally, who is a rag doll, who is Frankenstein-like creation of Finkelstein and Jack's love interest. And she is a toxicologist who uses various types of poison to liberate herself from the captivity of Finkelstein. She is also psychic and has a promotions when anything bad is about to happen. And we got Dr. Finkelstein, who is a mad scientist, and he is a kind but overbearing father of Sally, and he's listed in the credits only as evil scientist, and is only mentioned by name twice in the film. We got Oogie Boogie, who is the main antagonist, and he's also a great villain. Oogie Boogie, he's awesome. He has a passion for gambling and a rivalry with Jack. And we got Santa Claus, the the ruler of Christmas Town. And those trick-or-treat gangs, the witch, the devil, and the skeleton, they're all great characters. In fact, most of the characters are great. I mean, the plot, I even like the plot. I really like how they use Halloween and Christmas and combined it together to make a great film. And funny, it takes place in Halloween Town, and Jack was getting bored and he wants to do something new, and so he goes to Christmas Town. Yeah, something like that. Kidnapping Santa Claus and all that stuff. But then things go very wrong for Jack, and he has to find a way to fix and defeat Oogie Boogie. Even the songs are really catchy. I really like the songs. The ending was really beautiful as well. I like how it ended. Such a sweet ending. And the villain's defeat was... Yeah, in the end, turns out that Oogie Boogie was actually made out of bugs. And yeah, that was Oogie Boogie's defeat. His sin got cut and it ripped upon, and out came what he actually was made out of. And those were bugs. And he got defeated, and the bugs started to come off of him. Yeah. Even the voice acting, Chris Sarandon, Kathleen O'Hara, William Hickey, Glenn Shaddix, Ken Page, Ed Ivory, and Paul Rubens. Everyone did a great job with the voice roles. They were perfect for their roles. Yeah. I really like how they thought that it was a good idea to make a Halloween and a Christmas movie together, and they thought this idea and and it's a stop-motion animated fantasy holiday film. Which I think that works really good. And not only that, it was also nominated for the Academy Awards for Best Visual Effects. One of the first for the animated film. And it met with both critical and financial success, earning praise for, and it earned praise for its animation. The characters, the songs, even the score. I thought the score was pretty well done too. And not only that, this movie had become so popular ever since then. Like, every Halloween or every Christmas they played this movie, and I understand why it's so popular. Like, wow. This has got to be one of the greatest things that Tim Burton had ever done, along with James and the Giant Peach. Yeah, The Nightmare Before Christmas, I think this is a really great holiday film. Everything I could say, the characters, the songs, the directing and the editing, the animation, everything I could say about it, such a great film. And I do consider this Tim Burton's finest work. And yes, Nightmare Before Christmas, such a great film. So for my final rating for this movie, I'm going to give this movie a 7 out of 7. Outstanding film. And there you go. That was my review on The Nightmare Before Christmas. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you comment, like this video, subscribe to me, turn on notifications, and don't forget to send me a request. This is me signing off, and I'll see you guys later. Have a great day, and peace out, y'all.